Jesus died on the cross, gave up his blood, so worship him. Jesus died on the cross, gave up his blood, so worship him. Jesus died on the cross, gave up his love, so worship him. Oh, worship him. Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Fill this place. Enter in and have your way. We need your presence and your glory as we tell the Easter story. Some have come with hurting hearts. Touch and heal them from the start. We need your presence. Yes, we do. For we can do nothing without you.
That's right, dear God. You are our Lord. Touch us. Fill us with your word.
Worship Christ the King.
To thank you for what you did way back.
worship him and bless his holy name. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus, reigns.
Jesus, keep us near the cross throughout our precious fountain. Free to all the healing stream that flows from Calvary's mountain. Were you there when they crucified Jesus? Were you there when they nailed him to that cross? Were you there when they hung his head for you and you and you? Were you there when they nailed him to that cross?
We welcome you all in this place where our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ.
We are one big family gathered in Jesus' name.
Enjoy yourselves. There's so much more to learn if you dare.
But we'll just start by asking again.
Hey, family, were you there?
When they crucified my Lord, were you there? When they crucified my Lord, oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there? When they crucified my Lord.
Who has believed our report?
And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed?
For he shall grow up. Plant, and as a root out of a dry ground.
He hath no form nor comeliness, and
rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief.
And we hid, as it was our faces from him.
He was despised, and we esteemed him not.
Surely he had borne our griefs and carried our sorrows.
Yet we did see him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted.
But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed.
All we like sheep have gone astray.
We
have turned everyone to his own way.
And the Lord had laid on him the iniquity of us all.
He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth.
He was brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, he opened not his mouth.
He was taken from prison and from judgment. And who shall declare his generation?
He was cut off out of the land of the living. And for the transgression of my people was he stricken.
And he made his bread with the wicked and with the rich in his death.
Because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth.
Trimble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
I'm sorry, but somebody's gonna have to help me with this. Blasphemy is defined as the act of contempt towards God or a lack of reverence for God. So, am I right?
You're right.
So, how then could Jesus, who is God, be accused of blasphemy?
I don't know.
It was a setup. The high priests and elders of Sanhedrin all accused Jesus of blasphemy because they knew with that punishment, it was death. Because they wanted him dead.
But why?
Some men brought to Jesus a paralyzed man lying on the mat. And once he saw their faith, he said to the man, "Take heart, son. Your sins are forgiven." But by this time, some of the teachers of the law, they saw this. They said he was blaspheming because only God could save himself.
But he was God.
He was God.
We know that. They did too. They saw his teachings. They heard the miracles. But sometimes it's just less complicated to kill the truth. Because when you kill it, you don't have to deal with it.
So sad, but so true.
You know what's crazy, though?
Listen.
The death sentence had to be approved by Rome.
Right.
So Jesus was taken to Pontius Pilate. But Pilate could find no wrong in him. But because he feared the crowds, he let them decide Jesus' fate.
Crucify him. That's what the people yelled as the Jewish chief priest stirred them on. Crucify him. They were just jealous. They were afraid that the people would follow Jesus and not them.
I yelled as loud as I could. No, this is the man Jesus, the Messiah, the Savior. Don't you remember? He's the one that fed the thousands with the two fish and the five loaves of bread. He's the one that healed the sick and raised the dead. He's God in the flesh.
I yelled too. We all did.
Should we have done more to save him? Could we have done more to save him?
How could we? We were outnumbered.
That's right.
And just like that, Jesus was condemned to die.
He didn't save himself because of his love for us.
They beat him unmercifully.
The one who showed so much love and kindness and tender mercy to us all. They beat him beyond recognition.
They yelled at him. They spit on him.
As if that wasn't enough, they stripped him down naked, pressed a crown of thorns on his head, made fun of him, saying he was a king.
Behold, the king of the Jews, they mocked.
He was too weak to carry his own cross. A black man, Simon Cyrene, had to carry thorns to Golgotha. And there he was in an old red cross between two convicted criminals.
My Lord.
He died, and as Jesus struggled to breathe, the soldiers, they cast lots for his clothes. And people just passed by, shout insults at him.
After only a few hours, when his time had come, Jesus died and gave up his spirit. It wasn't taken from him.
What do you mean?
He gave it up. He said to his father, "Father, into your hands I give, I put my spirit." And then he hung his head and he died.
Why did it have to happen?
I mean, Jesus could have called the angels from heaven to rescue him.
Exactly.
He could have, but he didn't. He just didn't.
But why?
He had the power.
Yes.
He saved me from seven demons. He called those demons out and he said, "Come out." And they did, and they never came back.
We watched him deliver so many others, yet he could not save himself.
He would not save himself.
That's right.
He had the ability to get off that cross. But that wouldn't have been more difficult than walking on water or saving Lazarus from the dead. He could have even asked Abba Father to change his plans according to his life. But he didn't.
You keep saying he could have, he didn't. Would somebody please help me understand why?
He didn't because of his love for us. Do y'all not remember him saying that the Son of Man must die, that he must suffer many things and be rejected, that he must be killed?
I remember, but why? That still doesn't explain.
Okay. In the beginning, God said that Adam and Eve will have to die because they sinned. So every day, the high priest sacrifices a lamb for the sins of the people before God. Those lambs are offered in the place of men. But God made Jesus be the perfect sacrifice.
The perfect sacrifice?
You see, he was much better than a lamb because he was a man. He was the perfect substitute for every lamb slain. Then God himself would come and receive him and his blood just as a lamb to pay the price for all the sins of the world so that those who would believe in him would be saved and have the opportunity to live with him forever. He was the purpose. No, he was the only sacrifice sufficient enough to cover our sins. He was born to die so that we would live. That was his purpose. And you know what, John? Each of us have a purpose too. But our purpose will not be fulfilled unless we act on it.
You know, I understand all of that, but I still feel so sad.
Me too. Couldn't there have been another way? I mean, any other way for people to have been saved?
It was a very cruel death for such a person to love.
Why did you die so slow, Lord?
Why did you have to die this way?
I'm Christina Thompson for Don't Miss, and coming up, we've got the details on the premieres of Mad Men and American Odyssey, plus the season finale of Shameless. Stay tuned.
Thank you.
Tell
Peter and John that Jesus' body was missing, and I could hear my heart pounding in my chest as we tried to tell them.
Man, I didn't know what to think, so John and I, we ran back to see what was going on.
I ran as fast as I could to see what was happening.
But we found the tomb empty. Just as you said.
True.
Hold on, wait. No, except for the linen cloths that covered Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
It was in there neatly folded.
It was.
But other than that, it was empty.
I couldn't stop crying. I mean, where was Jesus? Where had they taken his body? I stood outside the tomb long after everybody else left. I just kept just crying and crying. And then something made me look into the tomb, and there inside the tomb, I saw two angels dressed in white. One was at the head and the other at the feet where Jesus' body had lain. And they said to me, they said, "Woman, why are you weeping?" And I said, "I don't know where they've taken my Lord. Where have they laid him?" And then I felt another presence. And I looked, and there was a man standing there. And he said to me, "Woman, why are you weeping? Who are you seeking?" And I thought he was a gardener or something. And I said, "Sir, if you've taken my Lord and Savior, you tell me where you've laid his body."
Mm-hmm.
And then he said to me, he said, "Mary." To my amazement, my surprise, it was Jesus.
Jesus?
He was alive.
Jesus. You know what? That same day, he appeared to us too. A friend and I was walking to the village of Emmaus, just a few miles from here. Mm-hmm. We were discussing everything that had happened earlier. All of a sudden, a man came up and walked along with us. He asked us what we were discussing. We told him about Jesus and how the chief priests and the other rulers handed him over to the Romans to be sentenced to death. We also told him how we had hoped that he was the Messiah. We also told him it was the third day since this had took place. One of our sisters came up to us and told us they could not find his body in the tomb where he was placed. Then they said they had seen a vision of angels who said he was alive.
Mm.
You know how women are, we told them.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, when we went, we found it just as the women had said. Then he said we should have believed what the prophet said about the Messiah, that he would have to suffer and then go on to glory. He explained all of the scriptures to us. He was so knowledgeable. As we got closer to the city, we asked him to have dinner with us. Then, at the table, he took the bread, gave thanks, and he broke it. And all of a sudden, our eyes were open and we knew it was Jesus.
Wow.
At that moment, he disappeared.
Mm.
It was so awesome. Wow. Then we ran back to Jerusalem as fast as we could. Tell the 11 disciples and everyone else that Jesus was alive.
Yes, Jesus.
And later he appeared to us also. He said, "Peace be with you." Then he showed us his hands and his side.
But when Jesus came, Thomas wasn't there. And y'all know how Thomas is.
Like, yes.
He said,
"Unless he can see the print of nails in his hands and put his fingers into the print of nails, unless he could take his fingers and put them to his side, he wouldn't believe." And about 8 days later, Jesus came to us again.
Yeah.
And guess who was there this time?
Oh, Thomas.
Thomas.
Thomas. Thomas. Jesus says to us, "Peace to you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your hands here and put your fingers in my side. Believe." Oh, man. Immediately, Thomas bowed down and said, "My God, my Lord." And then Jesus said to Thomas, "Thomas, because you have seen me, you want to believe. Blessed are those who have not seen, yet have believed."
"And we watched as his life kept away.
And we all stood around till the guards took him down. Joseph begged for his body that day.
It was late afternoon when we got to the tomb, wrapped his body and sealed up the grave.
So I know how you feel. His death was so real. So please listen and hear what I say.
I just seen Jesus. I tell you, he's alive. I've just seen Jesus, our precious Lord, alive.
And I knew he saw me too.
Just see Jesus.
Lord.
Isn't it wonderful? Jesus is alive.
Yes, it is. And because he got up, it proves that he is who he said he is.
Yes.
Who but God can raise himself from the dead?
Ha, nobody. Nobody has power over death but God himself. And Jesus' ability to raise himself from the dead proves that he was God.
That's right.
And he
That's
was right. with us all along.
That's right.
We didn't even know it.
The truth is, God's word became flesh. Yeah. And he made his dwelling right here among yes. us.
Right.
Man, we are so, so honored to have seen his glory. The glory of the one and only Son.
Yes,
we are honored. From the Father, full of grace and truth.
Yeah. And we are honored to have walked with him and talked with him.
And to have fellowship and communion with him.
And to have seen his many miracles.
Yes.
And me, to have been one of his miracles, because there is nobody who could else who could have saved me. Thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We are honored to have heard his teaching.
And to have been changed by his teaching.
And to have been saved by his teaching. You know, if we could just pay attention to those words and be doers of the words and not just hearers of the word, can you imagine the wonderful changes that could occur? Oh, my.
You know, Jesus saved my life.
Really?
When I was 9 or 10 years old, I thought I knew more than my parents about everything. And then when I turned like 12 or 13, I knew that I knew more than my parents about everything. And I was so ready to get out of their house. Y'all, they were so dumb. I knew that I would be better off on my own. And my friends thought the same thing too. I was so tired of cooking their food and cleaning up their messes and washing their dishes. The world just looked like so much better.
Been there.
I mean, but one day, I heard Jesus teaching. And he was saying things like, I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly.
Right.
Heard that.
Or things like, be sober-minded, be watchful.
True.
Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking for someone to devour.
All right.
Mm-hmm. And I found all of his teachings to be so on point and true.
Yes.
The world is so full of lies with everybody just out for themselves.
You right, mm-hmm. girl. You got that right.
Like they say, baby girl, every man for himself, but God is for us all.
All right.
All right.
You know, I watched one of my friends die too soon. Another one end up in jail, and another one has an incurable disease. I've seen how the more that people seek after the worldly things, the more that greed and unhappiness consume them. That could have been me, y'all.
Yeah.
In 1 week, I'll turn 18, and I'm so glad God brought me to my senses.
All right.
I realized that the food that I cooked and that I clean and the dishes that I wash was mine too. And I mean, my parents were once my age, and I guess they learned a couple things along the way. And I've learned that if I just learn from their mistakes and listen to some of the things that they're telling me, then my life would be so much better.
Yes.
But I'm so glad I dodged that dagger.
Yep.
So way to go, Satan.
Yes.
All right.
Now, just like you thought you had Jesus, you thought you had me.
All right.
But now, I'm going to spend the rest of my life going back into your kingdom and stealing back what you stole from the people of God.
All right. Now.
All right.
Let him know.
All right.
For you.
All right. Right.
Love.
What goes around comes around. Yes, yes.
That's
all right.
Share
okay.
your joy. I know that's right.
It's okay. It's good right. job. Yeah, it's good right. job. Wow. Oh.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Causes me to tremble.
All right, all right.
Tremble.
Oh, yeah.
Tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
I was there. Matter of fact, we all were there.
What? We were all at the cross with Jesus that day.
We were.
What do you mean?
Well, Isaiah 53:6 says, like sheep, we have all strayed away.
Right.
We have left God's path to follow our own. But yet, the Lord laid on him the sins of us all. Amen.
So, let me make sure I have this right. In other words, what you're saying is that all of our sins and all of the sins of those who came before us and all of the sins of those who are to come were laid on Jesus on the cross that day?
That's right. You got it.
Wow. My sins too?
Yours too.
So everyone was at the cross that day?
Everyone. You wow. see, he became sin so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
That is so powerful.
And there's more.
It is. Wow.
See, when we accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior,
right?
He becomes a sacrifice of our sins. And then we become one with him through Jesus' death and resurrection. Then we are saying to God that we accept his offer of forgiveness towards us.
Now I understand.
That's powerful. That's powerful. So, oh my gosh.
So when we go under the water for baptism, well, think of it as going into the grave like Jesus did. Well,
all right, all right.
Oh, but once we come up out of that water,
yes, all right, all right.
Think of it as being resurrected into eternal life, yeah, like Jesus did.
All right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. all right yes. now.
So our mission then becomes to make disciples of all.
Of all.
Baptizing them with the name of the Father,
wow.
Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And teaching them to obey God's every word so
wow.
that they will not only be participants in his death, check this out, but they will also be participants in his resurrection.
Wow.
Eternal.
Wow.
Eternal.
Wow.
I've got it.
So, I don't know about you guys, but I was at that cross that day, and I'm going to the kingdom, and I will do the work of the Lord. What about you guys?
I was there too, so I'm with you.
Yes, sir.
I'm in. Let's do it.
Anybody else?
You.
Hey.
I'm in.
I was at the cross and I'm in. I was at the cross and I'm in. I was at the cross and I'm in. I was at the cross and I'm in. How about you? How about you?
I was at the cross.
How about you?
Are you in?
Are you in?
Are you in?
Are you in?
How about you? How about you? I'm at the cross and I'm in. How about you? as we said before, the truth is that we were all at the cross that day. Because when Jesus died, he took with him the sins of us all. Minister Carey is going to come and sing, "Were You There?" as Bishop comes up and closes us out. Our message for today is that we were all at the cross that day with Jesus. And just as we said a minute ago, we died, and look at it like we died with him. We went into the cross. Our sins went into the grave with him. But when we're resurrected, like he was resurrected, we're resurrected into eternal life. Amen.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? I'm gonna say it one more time.
All right.
I said,
all
were
right.
you there
when
they hung him on the cross?
All right, all right.
Were you there? Oh, sometimes.
Yes, yes, yes. It causes me.
It causes me to tremble.
All right, all right.